The first step in creating a document set is identifying which documents are related and what information is common between them. The document set, again, is a content type. So let's go to the Tools menu and then select Site Contents. And then Site Settings. The content types are in the Web Designer galleries. And from here, let's click Create. First, we need to give it a name and a description. Always give it a description. So this will be an event document set. And then in the description, let's just identify that this is a set of documents for sales and catering events. Next, we need to identify the parent content type, where that content type is coming from, and which one we want to base this on. Let's look at the options. From here, we're going to choose the document set content types. If you do not see this option, it's because it has not been enabled on your server, and you'll need to work with your administrator to get that turned on. Because this is the very first one, we are only going to have one option here, and that's going to be the document set. Let's go ahead and place this in our existing group for events. And click OK. After you've created the document set, we now need to add the site columns that we would want to utilize within the document set. Let's click Add from Existing Site Columns. As you're adding your site columns, you want to be a little bit strategic here because they add them in the order that you select them. First, let's filter our groups for the event columns. And then select them in the order that you would want to enter them when you create a new document set. I'm going to select client name, event date, event manager, event type, the number of guests, and the budget. If you have additional columns you want to store, feel free to do that. What this does is it creates a column in your library that you can use to filter and sort and create reports on. Let's go ahead and add them all, and then click OK. The basic document set has been created, but we still have a little bit of work yet to do. Once we've created a document set, we need to customize it so that it works for us. First of all, our columns at the bottom are the site columns that we selected. And in many of our documents, some of this information is required, so we might want to update the columns to be required. For example, client name. In the column settings, currently this says optional. Let's make this required. And then click OK. We would want to do that on each one of the fields that are required throughout every document in the document set. Otherwise, you're going to have some conflicting information. I call these the key columns, and they will show up in many places throughout your document set. The next thing we need to customize is what documents do we want it to create automatically for us, and that's in the document set settings. There's a lot of things going on in this window. Let me pick it apart for you. At the top, we have the allowed content types. And this is where you say, these are the types of documents that are allowed to be in my document set. Below that, we have the default content. So when you create the document set, what documents does it automatically create for you? These are two different things and people get them confused. I wish they would put them in the opposite order, but I just teach these things. I don't write them. So at the top, we're going to say, these are anything that can be added into the document set. Let's filter the group for our event document types and add them all to the right. Next, we're going to do the default content. What are those documents that we want it to add automatically? And this gets a little bit tricky. In the content type column, what we're going to do is select which content type we want it to add. Let's start with the catering proposal. Here's where it gets tricky. Unfortunately, it doesn't work like I would like it to. It doesn't automatically look at where that catering proposal template is and upload it for me. You actually have to download it somewhere else and then upload it here. I don't know why, and I think it's frustrating, but I'm just sharing this little tip with you. So what I typically do is I'll go back to my template library, select the documents I would like to download, click Download, and then put them on my local computer, which I've already done for us in the interest of time. After you select the content type, upload the file. So I'm going to click Browse. And then browse to the documents where I've downloaded them. Then select it and click Open. We would do that for each of our content types, but there's a couple more tricks in here. Let's add a new default content type. And this time, let's use Banquet Event Order. In addition to creating the document set, you can organize it using folders. So let's say we want a folder called Banquets, because these are the documents they're going to need. Again, browse and choose the document. Let's do one more. This time the room diagram. And also put it in the Banquets folder. Browse, and then select the document. All right, we have designated what our default content is going to be when it creates a document set for us. The next option is to designate your shared columns. Which fields or which columns are shared between all of these documents? Again, to me, this is that key information that if I update it at the document set level, it will update all of the documents that are in the document set that contain this information. So things like the event date, the event manager, the client name. Those are key things that no matter what happens, I needed to update all of those documents. Event type, and let's do number of guests. And then finally, there's this little header section at the top of the welcome page when you land on your document set. What information do you want to display there? And again, I display that key information. Client name, event date, event manager, the type, maybe the budget, and the number of people. Usually about 6 to 8 fields. You don't want to get this too busy. And then the welcome page section is inherited. If you have child content types based on this one, it will update those as well. Then click OK. Our document set has now been updated with our request to changes. Our final step would be to add this to the library where we want to be able to add these document sets. Let's visit our catering site. In here, we have our events document library. To add the content type, first select the library settings from the Tools menu. And then scroll down to the content types. Click Add to Existing Content Types. And then choose Event Document Set and add it to the content types. And then OK. This typically puts the event document set at the bottom because I selected it last. I like to change them and put my document sets at the top. So let's change the new button order and the default content type. And we'll move this one to the top. Then click OK. Now in our new menu, we have the option for an event document set or the individual documents as we previously added them.